Así que ya nos escuchó el teacher, creo.
Hace falta.
Sí.
No logré traer a la perspectiva de lo que piensa por entonces ya me hace y lo ve como para esto.
Good evening.
Good evening, María.
Good evening.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi.
Good evening.
Good evening, teacher.
How are you guys?
Teacher, good evening.
Fine. Good evening. How are you?
Fine, teacher. You?
Great.
Good evening.
Good evening, Azalia.
Azalia, hi. Good evening.
Hi. Alguien me dejó ahí pendiente.
I'm sorry.
Could it be me?
Cierto.
Pending about what? Okay. Okay. Hello. Darwin.
Hello.
Angela.
Hello.
How was your weekend?
Good.
Funny. Yeah? Funny. Yes. Funny or funny?
Excellent.
With
excellent. Hey Giovanni, work. Welcome. Much work. A lot of work. Hey Giovanni.
In this moment, I'm driving for my house.
You're driving home, okay. Good, be careful.
Hey, thank you.
Be safe. So, how was your weekend? Let's start practicing English. I know some of you are working, some of you are driving home, but for the ones in the class already, let's practice. Okay, so tell me, how was your weekend? Okay, I'm gonna go one by one. I hear some noise. Okay, I'm gonna go one by one of you making the question. How was your weekend? How was your weekend? Okay, so I'm gonna start with Angela de Jesus. How was your weekend?
Con mucho trabajo.
A lot of work.
Work.
Okay. What did you do?
¿Cómo se dice iglesia en inglés?
Church.
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 Uh-huh.
So you went.
Yes.
Okay.
En los quehaceres del hogar, no sé cómo decir.
Home chores. Okay.
With son muchos.
Did you spend time with your family?
Excuse me, teacher. No.
Did you spend time with your family?
Que si de mí depende de mi familia. No.
Did you spend time with your family? With your family, did you spend time watching TV or?
I never watching TV.
You never watch TV.
Uh-huh. Okay. Porque, como decía, porque.
Because. No.
Because a lot much work.
I had a lot of work. Okay, let's see. Carla Vasquez, how was your weekend? Thank you, Angela.
Thank you, teacher.
As always, I was working during the weekend. I work at Ericsson
Monday to Friday. On weekend, I work in my business. Every weekend.
On the weekend, yes. Okay.
Yes. No more, only work.
Okay, just working. Okay, yes. So you worked on Saturday the 1st, May 1st? Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Okay.
The day off is when my work increases. Yes, increases because the business is ice cream business.
Oh, good. That's good.
Yes.
Okay, good job. Okay, Sandra Gladys, how was your weekend? Hello, hello, Sandra Gladys.
Me. Hi, teacher.
Hi.
I went visited Chalatenango at the Sumpul River. With my family and my friend. And beef.
You ate beef? Okay, a barbecue?
Beef. Asada, ¿cómo se dice? Barbecue.
A barbecue, huh?
Barbecue. And Sunday,
we rested. Okay.
We rested.
Awesome, very good. Darwin, what about you? How was your weekend?
I had an excellent weekend. The Saturday in the morning, visit the church in the lower the city. And the Saturday afternoon, play the video game for my brother. And the Sunday, watch the series in Netflix, for example, The Last Kingdom.
The Lost Kingdom. Really? That's the name, right? Lost Kingdom? Wow. Is it good? Is it good, Darwin? The Lost Kingdom, is it a good series? Yes? Good. Okay, great. Okay, yes. Great job. Maria Stella, how's it going?
Hi, teacher. On the weekend, I have a family reunion.
Reunion? Okay, a family meeting?
Reunion.
Mm-hmm.
Reunion. Because my can also on Sunday, I have a video conference? Biblioteaching.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Good. Yes. What do you teach?
Biblion. Biblia.
Oh, Bible.
Bible.
Bible teaching. Bible, okay. Yeah.
Bible Got teaching.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Awesome.
I have BC weekends.
Excellent. Okay, that's really good. Okay. Ana Michelle.
Good evening.
Hi, good evening. How was your weekend?
In my case, that's good. It was good because on Saturday, I spent time with my family. And Sunday, I went to visit my uncles.
On Sunday? Really? Okay.
Yes.
Where do they live?
Soyapango.
Soyapango, okay.
Yes.
Good, okay, I'm glad to hear that you had fun. One more, okay, a volunteer, one more volunteer.
Me, Nelson.
Excellent, Nelson, how was your weekend?
Last weekend, I was busy because Saturday I was working, and the later I visit my mother and all my family, because in my sister, my brother, and the Sunday and for morning or and rest in the morning. Yeah, I went to church, and in the afternoon I stayed resting. I slept for a long time in the night. In the night was studying in little. Yeah.
Excellent. That's okay. Good job. Okay. Everybody, you say on Monday, on Tuesday, on Wednesday, on Saturday, on Sunday, on the weekend.
On okay? Sunday.
Okay. On Sunday, on Saturday, on the weekend. Okay. And you say church. Repeat church.
Church.
There you go. Church. Remember, in the morning, in the afternoon, in the evening, okay, at night.
Okay. Okay. At night.
Prepositions in, on, at. Don't forget. Very important. Okay. Before we move on, I have to do the attendance. Today is May 3rd. May 3rd, Monday. Garfield. Okay. Ada Patricia Linares Galdames.
Present, teacher.
Ana Michelle Guevara Sanchez.
Present.
Ángela de Jesús Santa María.
Present, teacher.
Salia Melanie Guardado Portillo.
Is new teacher. Present.
Portillo. Darwin Edgardo Ayala Leiva.
Present, teacher.
Thank you, Darwin. Fidel Coreas Pascual. Not yet. Okay, Flor de María Carballo Ugarte.
Present.
Thank you. Gloria Elizabeth Linares Galdames.
Here.
Thank you. José Ángel Pereira Romero. No. Okay. Carla Vanessa García de Pérez. There she is. Okay. Carla Verónica Vázquez de Rivas.
Present.
Thank you. María Estela Varela Velázquez.
Present.
Thank you. Mayra Melanie Guevara de Beltrán.
Present.
Thank you. Nelson Edgardo Sánchez Ramírez.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Ofelia Orellana Arce.
Y.
Ofelia. Oh, there she is. Okay. Thank you. Osmin Baires Olórzano.
Present, teacher.
Rafael Ernesto González Ventura.
Here.
Thank you. Roselena Salgado de Serrano. Viene, me dijo. Yes. Yes, thank you. She's driving. Be careful. Yeah, I got you. Sandra Gladys Méndez de Barahona. Sandra Gladys.
Here, teacher.
There she is. Thank you. Okay.
Here, teacher.
Thank you. Yancy Lisbeth Hernández Mejía. Igual va para su casa. Thank you. Edwin Rolando Méndez Chicas.
Here, teacher.
Good. Okay. Para los que van manejando, por favor, tengan cuidado. Giovanni Alexander Mengiva Rivera.
Here, teacher.
And Zulma Rosaura López García.
Present.
Okay. Bien, solo tenemos dos compañeros que se han ausentado. Bueno, Fidel, imagino que ya se va a unir otro momento. Chicos, a ver. Esta es nuestra última semana, luego ya viene el martes 11 de mayo y cerramos el módulo, ¿qué es? ¿3, verdad? ¿Intermedio 3?
Yes.
Casi que intermedio, porque les cuento, teniendo 7 años de experiencia en esto, y pues de los cuales 5 serían con Regal ya, en esta empresa, les puedo decir, ustedes ya hablan. Créanlo o no, o sea, todo ya se comunican y eso es un gran avance. En el sentido este de que ya es la última semana, invitarlos a que ya no falten. Es muy probable que si has faltado unas 2, 3 veces a clase, te falten horas para cerrar el módulo. Y recordar que hay 2 cosas esenciales para pasar el módulo y seguir con la beca, porque es una beca, ¿no? Uno, estar en la clase, completar el número de minutos, de horas, y 2, pues completar la plataforma. Esta semana se les están enviando los documentos, según me han dicho. Permítanme que hay un ruidito por ahí, como que están en una iglesia. Just one second. Ok, voy a... Perdón, vamos a ver. Ok, ahí está. Ok, perdón que los haya puesto en silencio a todos, pero quiero que quede claro esto. Esta semana se les van a enviar los documentos, o ya se les enviaron. Por favor, si no se han enterado de que su departamento de recursos humanos ya envió la documentación, pedirles que estén ahí con el dedo en la llaga, como decimos, ¿verdad? Para que esos documentos lleguen a inglés corporativo y podamos darle continuidad al curso, al básico 4, en la brevedad posible, que es por lo cual inglés corporativo es famoso, porque no hay pausas de 2 meses, de 3 meses para el siguiente módulo, y eso es beneficioso para ustedes más que todo, porque a pesar de que este programa dura 18 módulos, un mes por módulo, en algunas academias o en algunas universidades donde se imparte este módulo, esta metodología, los de intermedio, por ejemplo, se supone que deben de durar 6 semanas, ya no 4. Sin embargo, nosotros pues hemos hallado una manera para acortar ese tiempo y siempre hacer las 4 semanas. Luego se darán cuenta, igual los cursos de avanzado deben de durar 6 semanas, pero nosotros hallamos la mejor manera para que ustedes se acoplen a ese tiempo y vayamos haciendo como 30 minutos, digamos, más al día, ya cuando lleguen intermedio y avanzado. ¿Y esto qué hace? Pues que ustedes completen el programa completamente en 2 años o menos. O sea, en otro lugar, si te querés completar ese programa, te tardas 2 años y medio, 3, fuera de broma. ¿Por qué? Porque no, muchos se van, nos quedan huecos en los grupos, y ya la historia que ya se dieron cuenta, ¿no? Ya están en básico test, ya se dieron cuenta de cómo es el teje y maneje, como decimos, de esto, de las inscripciones, ¿no? Entonces, invitarlos a que no falten ya, en absoluto. Les agradezco de nuevo por estar acá. Let's...
Good evening, teacher.
Do this. Hello, Vanessa. Ok. Welcome. Bien. Questions, preguntas acerca de eso.
Yo los envié ahora, teacher.
Perfect. Muy bien, muy bien. Estar ahí pendiente de que se reciban, de que ya está su documentación para que ya... No, ni siquiera vas a andar preguntando ya después, mira y recibí mi documento. No, ya están, ya sabes que ahí están, muy bien. Cualquier consulta en relación a eso de los papeles y las inscripciones, ahí en el grupo de WhatsApp están los administradores con el logo de inglés corporativo, ¿verdad? Si ustedes tienen alguna duda, ¿ok?
Okay.
Good, let's start. So, today we're going to start with our dynamic on 2 ways, ¿ok? I want you to work with restrictions in your job. So let me get an example from Rafael. Can you name 1 restriction in your job? What you cannot do in your job?
You shouldn't have
relationships
with the other co-workers.
Okay. So I cannot have relationships with other co-workers. With another coworker. Okay. Good. That's an example. So prohibitions. Things that you cannot do in your job. Okay. Think about it. and give your examples to your classmates. Now, let's work this way. Things that you cannot do, things that you can do, okay? And things that you could do. So for example, I cannot have relationships with another coworker or coworker. I should be on time every day. I could do my job better. I could do my job better. Okay, these are things that you could do to improve your job. Okay, so this class is a review of unit 3. This class is a review of unit 3. We're gonna start checking things that you should do in your workplace, you can do, you could do, okay? Restrictions and things that you could do, okay? Is that clear? No, yes. Yeah, remember, yeah. It's just the models. It's just the models, use models. Do you want to remember how to use the models? In fact, help me, help me. Everybody, give me the structure we use for models.
Should, can.
Okay, let's go first with an affirmative sentence. Come on.
Subject,
okay.
Model.
It's on your chat, yes. It's on the WhatsApp, huh?
Model verb.
Base verb, okay.
Base verb.
What else?
Complement.
And the complement. These are affirmations. Very good. Give me an example. Sandra Gladys.
Teacher. She can write the letter.
Perfect. There you go. That's it. She can write letter. Okay. She cannot write the letter. Next question.
Mm-hmm. Can she write letter? Yeah.
Easy, you see? Simple. Now you have positive, negative question. Okay? As simple as that. Don't forget the structure. Si has estado practicando durante estos días, has hecho algo. I'm sure. Estoy seguro de que ya la estructura se te tiene que ir quedando y la única manera de adquirirla y de no olvidarla es practicando. So, restrictions at your job. Restricciones en tu trabajo. Questions? Questions?
Question.
No questions. Okay, let's do it then. Let's get this started. Remember, speak English. Speak English. Let's go.
Edgardo.
Hello.
Gloria.
Vamos a hacer preguntas, ¿no?
Yes. Can you can share your screen?
Entonces, lo que yo no sé si...
Who shared the screen in the...
No se nos permite en los lugares de trabajo.
¿En la pantalla?
Pero lo que no sé es si con esa base hacer las oraciones...
¿Quién lo podría compartir en la pantalla? La opción de compartir así. Yo no, no lo he intentado y quiero intentarlo.
La base de datos vez. Ha sido actualizada. Diga, Gloria, diga. La base de datos ha sido actualizada. La quiero oír también. Tono de voz. We're good. Okay, guys. Restrictions in your job. ¿Qué restricciones tenés en el trabajo? Sí, en realidad.
Yes.
Restrictions that you have. ¿Cuál es la más fuerte? ¿Cuál es la restricción más fuerte? Por lo que te pueden despedir si estás como... Ups. En mi caso, develar, ¿cómo se dice? Disclose. Publicar información sensitiva de los clientes de las tarjetas en redes sociales o compartirla con alguien. Salud, trabajo y demanda segura. For example. Okay. And that's disclose.
In my office, nothing. Por escrito, no hay nada por escrito.
There is nothing writing.
But, pero sé que hay muchas reglas que no debemos.
In my case, is char information confidential.
Confidential information.
Yeah.
In my work, lo que dice la compañera, no hay nada por escrito, pero
sabemos. Ahí está en el chat. There's nothing in written. There's nothing in written. Sharing confidential information, Olsen. So.
Yes. Okay.
Si no hay restricciones por escrito en mi trabajo, no estoy al tanto de las restricciones, pues imaginemos que trabajamos en un banco, que trabajamos, no sé, ¿qué lugar es así difícil que tú digas, wow, haya de ser duro trabajar? Bueno, se los dejo a su creatividad. Una empresa difícil en la que ustedes trabajan, es la alcaldía, igual. Oh. Cosas que no puedes dejar salir de la alcaldía. Oh my God. Okay. Good. Go ahead, guys. Go ahead. Talk.
Thank you.
Así es.
¿Quién me interrumpió?
Ese sería. Teacher, excuse me. Fíjese que me distraje un momentito. Y... no le entendí si la tarea es de acuerdo a al decir las cosas que no se nos permiten en nuestros lugares de trabajo, de acuerdo a eso, vamos a hacer las oraciones afirmativas y negativas y preguntas. ¿Así es?
Sí, más que todo les estaba recordando la estructura de los modales, pero ahorita de decir lo que me es permitido en el trabajo, las cosas que podría hacer mejor en el trabajo, ok, y las cosas que sí se me permiten hacer en el trabajo,
ok,
para todo eso puedo ocupar modales, could, should, can, okay. good, ok,
thank you,
go ahead,
hoy sí.
Product de how do you say higiene personal?
Personal hygiene.
Personal?
Hygiene.
Hygiene. In my type, my company produces personal hygiene.
My company produces?
In my company produces personal hygiene. Then we cannot eat in the areas produced. Only eat in the cafeteria.
In the
the restriction.
Cafeteria.
Cafeteria.
Okay. Eat in the cafeteria.
Darwin. Darwin, yes. At your work, you have a special place to to eat.
Do you have a special place for eating?
There is a special place for eating? To eating?
Is there? Is there a special place?
Okay. Is there a special place for taking the meals? Yeah? Okay.
Yes?
Yes or not?
The cafeteria. Yes.
The cafeteria.
Oh, okay. Okay.
So in my work, there is a special place to take in the meals, but in my case with my partners, we take the meals in the warehouse. We have a space with some tables and we take the lunch there.
We share lunch there.
Yeah, we share lunch there.
Mm-hmm. Okay, how about you, Maria Estela?
The restriction in my job, I can't use the informal dress.
Oh.
Yes, because it's a sales area.
It's a sales area.
Yes. It's contact with the person.
We have contact with the customers, with the clients.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. The vocabulary.
I need to be polite.
Yes.
At all times. Yes. Repeat, at all times.
At all times.
At all times. At all times.
At all times.
At all times. Okay. Wow. It's very difficult. Darwin, what about you? Are there restrictions to go on the production floor? Are there restrictions to go in the production floor?
In my case, other restriction is we cannot use the cell phone in the
office and the workplace.
En las áreas productivas también.
Okay, in the production floor. Look at the chat. In the production floor, the production plant.
The production plant. In the office, just in the phone.
Mm-hmm. You can use the phone in the office. What about you, Rosalina? Can you use your cell phone in the office?
Yes. Yes,
but not for personal things.
We can use it for personal things.
Of course, limited.
Oh yeah, all the time. No. For example, at the warehouse, nobody can get in. Yeah, nobody Perfect. Can get in if somebody get into the warehouse, we have to put the name in a bitácora.
In the journey. Don't forget that word. In the journey. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay. The people that get into the warehouse put the name in the journey and put the hour to get in and the hour to get out. It's a rule.
It's mandatory. It is a rule. Perfect. Okay. Keep going.
I was so confused about these models because could and would we use for
polite request. Mm-mm. Ensure, mm-mm. No necessary. No necessary.
The opposite. I mean, yes, you can, for polite requests, you can use the models. All models. All models. We will see that the degrees in which you can use the models right now. I'll explain you. Just remind me, okay? Because I will explain to everyone the degrees.
Thank you for suggestions.
That's right.
But I was so confused. I don't know.
Suddenly, don't worry.
I was confused.
I will explain to you all in the class so everybody has it clear. Thank you. Okay. Once we come back, I'll give you the degrees in which it goes. Thank you. Okay. Right now, let's focus on the structure. On the structures, okay? Keep going.
Okay.
Yes. What a terrible.
Yes. Como que hay que hacer un esfuerzo, no sé. Este, o sea, quiere bastante.
You have to go the extra mile.
Yes. In this,
I can eat vegetables.
You cannot.
With lunch.
I love it.
You cannot eat vegetables.
Vegetable.
Why? Why do you get sick?
No, daily. Dieta?
Okay. Do you have a diet?
Diet.
Are you in are you in a diet?
No.
Who's in a diet?
No.
Why are we talking about food?
No.
Okay, girls. What are the restrictions in your job? What things you cannot do in your job?
We talk, for example, in my work, mm-hmm. I can use jeans on Monday to Thursday.
Okay, from Monday?
From Monday.
To Thursday.
To Thursday.
Thursday. Okay, from Monday through Thursday, I cannot wear jeans.
Yes, only Fridays.
Only Fridays. Mm-hmm.
Friday.
It's a casual day. It's a casual day, a casual dress code. Casual dress code. Okay, do you wear a polo shirt?
No, jeans.
Just different. Jeans.
Yes.
So you cannot wear a polo on Friday?
No.
No. Okay.
No. Sí. ¿Cómo se dice? Tacones y blusa formal y jeans es la única diferencia.
Formal blues and high heels.
High heels. Tacones. Mm-hmm. Okay, good.
In my joy general, I cannot restriction.
You don't have
using jeans always.
So no matter the day, I can wear jeans or casual anytime. So look at the chat. Look at the chat, Sandra and Gladys. No matter the day, I can wear jeans or casual anytime.
Yes.
No matter the day. Yes. No importa el día. Okay, good. Okay, keep going, girls. Just one more minute and we go back.
Thank you.
Okay. Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome.
More.
In my company, we can go home at 2 p.m. on Fridays.
Really?
Yes, we have a Flexi Friday.
Oh my God.
Yes.
I envy you.
Yes, but con la cuarentena, ay Dios. Trabajando desde casa no se siente.
Yeah, true. Okay, what other restrictions have you found?
Vamos a ver.
What about Rafa? Is there a restriction at the university for shaving? No?
No.
It's okay. Okay. No restrictions for your facial hair. Okay.
No.
What about the dress code?
Is
casual, formal?
It's not an obligation, but use the formal clothes.
Mm-hmm.
But the, como digo, la mayoría.
¿Mayoría de qué?
De empleados.
Okay, most part of employees.
Most part
of employees.
Of employees like use formal clothes.
Like to use. Mm-hmm. Like to use formal. Like to dress.
Okay.
Like to dress formal.
I put the dress formal.
Mm-hmm.
So, all we.
We all dress. Repeat. We repeat. We all follow.
We all follow.
We all follow. We all follow the trend. We all follow the trend. Are you trendy, Rafa?
Trending is como tendencia.
Uh-huh. Are you trendy? Michi, are you trendy? No. Melanie, are you trendy?
No.
No.
Melanie, are you trendy? No. No, I don't know what is trendy. Melanie, no, what is trendy? What is trendy? Because it's not, it is.
¿A qué?
Tendencia, uh-huh. Trendy.
¿A qué?
Like, for example, me, I'm wearing a black shirt today, and maybe if I wear a tie, you know, but trendy. For a man, if you are trendy, you are metrosexual. If you are too trendy, si sos demasiado a la moda, I don't know how to say this in Spanish. Trendy es fashionista, right? And you
I'm
follow.
Far. I'm far. Very far.
Very far. I'm far from trendy. Me too. Me too. I don't like brands, you know, like, that's not okay. I mean, for me, I will never pay, I don't know, $50 for a shirt. Okay. I will pay $200 for a suit, for a full suit, you know, with the, yeah, everything, with the jacket, the pants, the tie, the shirt. I will pay $200 for a suit, but never for just for one shirt. No, thank you. That's too much money. That's crazy. I think even if I had the money, listen, even if I had the money, never, too much money. What is the most, I want to talk to you, let's see. What is the most that you will spend in a shirt, in a blouse? Let's compare the girls, Rafa. Uh-huh, Ana Michelle. What is the most, how much can you pay for a blouse, Melanie?
Oh.
Hoy resulta que se le fue el internet. Ah.
For me, not a blouse, but a coat.
A coat, uh-huh. A jacket.
A jacket. I pay.
I would pay.
I would pay 65.
Up to 55. There's where you say 65. Up to hasta. You know, up to $65. Maybe for a leather jacket. Una chaqueta de cuero.
Eso era peor de todo, que ni era de cuero. Era como de...
¿Jeans?
No, como de gamuza.
Oh, oh.
Yes.
Okay. Brand?
Yeah.
A good brand? Okay. Melanie, yes. What about you, Melanie? How much would you pay for a blouse or a jacket or some jeans? ¿Cuánto es lo más que pagarías?
No, por... teacher. La verdad no sé por qué. Es que yo no compro ropa.
Ok.
Ni me la traen.
Even better. That's what happens to me as well. I mean, they bring my clothes. I never buy clothes. It's really weird.
Sí, no, yo...
Unless...
Years.
No. Years and years. The same thing with me. Unless I fall in love with a tie or, I don't know, with some jeans. If I look at them and I go, oh, I want those. I buy them. Yeah, but it's really weird.
Or chamarra, shoes. Chamarra jean.
Jacket?
Chamarra, ¿cómo se dice? Jacket.
Jacket.
De cuero.
A leather jacket. It's on the chat.
15.
$15?
Lo más, digo yo.
Okay, sí. Good.
Yes.
Okay, Rafa, what about you? What is the most you will pay for a jacket?
In my case, la camisa de vestir, how do you say it?
Okay, formal shirt.
Only buy formal shirt. I could pay
up to
$30-$35.
Okay, for a Pierre Cardin.
It's same for pants, for jeans.
Same for jeans. Good. See, hey, you talk. Great job. Good job, guys. Let's go back. Okay. Welcome back, Mayra. I think you're back. Fidel, good evening, welcome. Okay, we're coming back. Okay, we are reaching that point where I won't let you speak Spanish, where I will force you to speak English. Doesn't matter if you make a mistake, it's okay. Okay, I was saying, let me repeat.
We should speak English.
We should speak English. So we have reached that point where you cannot speak Spanish. Doesn't matter. Make mistakes, please. So let's continue. I will force you to speak English, okay? Don't cry, please. Be strong. Don't be shy. It's gonna help you. Okay, so last topic we covered was very simple, I think. It was always with models. And we're getting close to unit 4, right? So we talked about etiquette. Remember, that was the last topic. We talked about etiquette and things you should do, things you shouldn't do. Roselena. Okay. Good. Now I need you to pay close attention to this because it's very important. And I will just explain it this time. So the models that we have studied are, there's a degree of imperativeness. Let's call it. Okay, Michi, can you Google this? A degree of imperativeness. Try to translate that, please. A degree of imperativeness. So, rudeness, if you want. Okay. A degree of rudeness and politeness. Okay. If you use this, let's say, index of models, they go this way. So let's say for on a scale from 100% rudeness to 0%, okay? 0% rudeness. Okay, Michi, what did you find?
It's correct, right?
What is the translation for some of your classmates?
Imperatividad.
Okay, but degree? Degree of imperativeness.
Grado de imperatividad.
Okay, what's rudeness and what's politeness?
Rudeness, como groserías.
Being rude, right? And I meant to say here politeness. Well, rudeness. So let's leave it there.
Amable.
Yeah.
Amable. Lo contrario de amable.
And the opposite. Very good. Rude. Rude.
Rudo.
Okay.
Rudo.
Grosero. Rudo. Grosero, rudo, right? Okay. Pesado, mal educado. That's mal. Cae mal. Okay, good. So let's see. If I say can, okay, I'm forcing. Okay, I'm forcing someone. Okay, I'm forcing someone to do. Okay. Okay, if I say can, I'm forcing someone. For example, can you close the door? Can you close the door? It doesn't matter how good I sound, how fancy I sound. Melanie, can you close the door? Can you close the door, please? Please. Okay, it doesn't matter, right? If I say can, now, can you close the door? That's rude, okay?
No.
You're forcing someone, thank you. Can you close the door? Now, if I say please, maybe, okay? I can say please, please. Okay, that sounds more polite. Okay, if I say could, okay, again, it's an imperative. I'm telling the other person, basically telling the other person it is necessary. Okay, it is necessary. Or asking if they have the ability. What is ability? What's ability?
Habilidad.
Come on, guys. Yes. So I'm telling the other person it is necessary, or I'm asking the other person if they have the ability. For example,
could you dance?
Uh huh.
Could Rosa? You dance?
Could you dance?
Could you dance?
Mm, more in in a job environment. I could tell someone in the job, "Hey, could you dance?" At work, can you ask someone at work?
Could you print the document?
Could you? Yeah.
Right. Could you dance? Mm-hmm. Let's go with the office, okay? Could you unjam? How do you say?
Could you send me the mail?
How do you say desatascar? I don't think it's unjam. Unjam. Check it. Mm-hmm. Because
jam is a
cut. Yeah, jam. The paper is jammed, did you say, right? Uh-huh. Jammed, right? But how can you say desatascar?
Unjamming.
Unjam, yeah. Right, good, Rosa. So, you, I see Fuzzy teacher. Okay, do you see clear? Do you see clear the screen? Can you see the screen?
Yes.
Yes, okay. So, could you unjam? Is that correct? The paper from the printer. Okay. Okay, could you send a fax? Could you send a fax? Okay. If you ask this to a teenager in your job, could you send a fax? They will go like, what is a fax? What is a fax, President? I don't know. Oh, you mean an email? An email.
They don't exist.
What? Of course there are. There are faxes. Are there no faxes anymore? There are no faxes anymore? Really? Oh my God. Okay.
One.
Only for antiques. Antiques anywhere. I don't know.
Could you send me a viper? I can't remember. I can't even remember. You remember the vipers?
Yes, we have a viper.
Vipers.
What?
Yes. We found a viper at the office. And the owner has an how do you say the thing?
Oh, in a window.
In a window.
Yeah. Okay. Window shopping window. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm, okay. So could telling the other person it is necessary or asking if they have the ability. Now, if I need this person to be in the office. Okay, could you do me a favor? Could you be here at 10 a.m.? At 10 sharp. Could you be here at 10 sharp? I have to go. So, telling someone that it is necessary for them to perform an action. Could you do me a favor? Could you be here at 10 a.m., at 10 sharp? I have to go.
Could you bring me a coffee?
Could you bring me a coffee? Is that necessary?
No, pero.
Think about something. Think about something urgent. Urgent. How would you ask this question to your boss? Okay, look. Mm-hmm.
Can you pay me? Could you pay me?
Let's do an exercise really quick. Okay. Let's go with the first one. How do you translate that? ¿Me puede pagar?
Can you pay me?
Can you pay me? Listen.
Can you pay me?
Boss, can you pay me?
Can you pay me? Please?
Not please. Oh my God. Can you pay me? Okay, let's go with the second one.
Could you pay me?
Could you pay me?
Could you pay me, please?
Con, hi, algo, boss. Con algo de penita.
Could you pay me?
Could you pay me? Hi, boss. Could you pay me?
How are you?
I'm hungry.
I need you.
I need money.
I need.
Okay. ¿Me pagaría?
Should you pay me?
Good. Would you pay me? Okay. And what about the last one? ¿No debería pagarme?
Shouldn't you pay me?
Excellent. Now, so listen. Okay. And I'm just in the models. Would you pay me? I'm just saying the same in everyone. Each one. And then the last one, because I can only make that question a negative. Okay, I have to use it in negative. Okay, just think about this. Think about this exercise. Every time you have a doubt, when you're in doubt. So, 100% rudeness, can, 70% could, then you go with would, and that's in the middle. Right, okay. Would is like the most polite way of asking something. Okay. Would. Small probability. This is very polite. Because this you're giving a big window for someone to say no. Okay, if you use would, you're being very polite, and you're just leaving a big window for someone to say no. I can't. I'm really sorry. I can't. So, for example, and in fact, this is used to make offers as well. For example, would you like some water? Look, would you like some water? Would you like something to drink? Anything to drink, I'm sorry. Would you like anything to drink? Okay, give me another example. We saw this. Would you
come with me to the party?
Would you come to dale con la fiesta?
Monday.
It's Monday, Rosalina. Rosalina. Hold your horses. Remember, Frank Sinatra, hold your horses. Okay, yeah, would you come to the party with me? To the office party? Osmin, come again.
No, yo tengo un problema con el sonido, teacher, por eso he conectado el micrófono.
Oh, okay.
Would you come to the meeting with me?
Perfect. Would you come to the meeting with me? Now, we saw this, remember? How do you say te importaría?
Would you mind?
Remember, would you mind? So there, now remember, when you ask, would you mind, you cannot say yes. You cannot say yes. You have to say no. It's okay. What else? No, I wouldn't mind. I already violated the previous rule. Don't worry. No worries. Go ahead. No hay problema, seguí. No hay problema. Dale. No worries. Go ahead. No problem. It's okay. No worries. No hay problema. No worries, go ahead. Okay. So, is that clear with would you mind? Now, I want to make sure. Are we clear on this? How you can sound rude or not if you say something like this? Does this make sense? ¿Se perdieron todos o cómo vamos?
Good.
Good, chair. It's clear.
It's clear.
Clear.
It's clear.
Okay. Okay. Vamos a ver. Patricia, su jefe le debe 2 semanas de salario y usted ya no tiene para la comida. ¿Qué le va a decir?
¿Cómo era? Could you pay me?
Could you pay me? Okay, good.
Please.
Please. Could you pay me, please? Okay. Good, good, good. El teléfono lleva 30 minutos sonando, Melanie. Y su compañera es la única que está sin hacer nada. Todo el mundo está ocupado y usted tiene 2 líneas ya ocupadas.
Así paso.
Ok, pero ¿cómo le va a decir a su compañera? Ojo, es su compañera, tiene confianza con ella. ¿Cómo le diría usando modales?
Could you help me, please?
That's a way, yeah. Could you help me?
Sorry.
¿Cómo? Could you answer the phone? Ojo, ya tenés confianza con esa compañera de trabajo. O sea.
Would you mind answering the phone?
No, de un solo decir, can you pick up the phone, please? Es la realidad, así le diría. Can you pick up the phone, please?
Sí.
Okay. Okay. Y entendiendo esto, yo puedo ser muy polite. Would you help me answering the phone? No me hizo caso. Hey, could you pick up the phone? No me hizo caso. Hey, can you please answer that call? I'm busy. 2 líneas.
A children.
Hoy sí,
no le hice caso.
Would, could, can. Okay.
Would.
Okay, repita. So I go. Would. Okay, would.
Would.
Uh-huh. Could.
Would.
Could.
Uh-huh.
Y luego can.
Can. Okay.
Y la manera más pesada de dar una orden. Uh-huh. Sin modales. Ocupo imperativos. Answer the phone.
Answer the phone. Direct.
Answer the phone. Yeah, you got it? So you go very polite, rude. That's what it is. So look, in the language, you have 4 options. It's like with your kids, right, Flor? Like with your kids. Así como con los niños. You go 1 time. Would you do your homework? Maybe could you do your homework? Can you do your homework? That's do your homework. You go. Same thing. You're giving orders.
Spooky. Always me.
Spooky.
With my dog.
Miedo.
Spooky. Spooky. Yeah, you can say spooky. Okay. And that's scolding. That is scolding. When you scold someone. Okay. Now, is it clear? Is it clear how to use models?
Yes, teacher.
You have degrees, right? Okay.
Okie
dokie. 9:10. It's 9:10, guys. Let's do the attendance one more time. Time flies. Ada Patricia Linares Galdamez.
Present.
Thank you. Ana Michelle Guevara Sanchez. Oh my God. Michelle is gone. Her internet connection, maybe. Yeah. Okay. Ángela de Jesús Santa María.
Present.
Thank you. Azaria Melanie Guardado Portillo.
Present.
Darwin Edgardo Ayala Leiva.
Present, teacher.
Fidel Coreas Pascual.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Flor de María Carballo Ugarte.
Present.
Thank you. Gloria Elizabeth Linares Galdames.
Here.
Thank you. José Ángel Pereira Romero. Carla Vanessa García de Pérez.
Here.
Carla Verónica Vázquez de Rivas.
Present.
María Estela Varela Velázquez.
Present.
Mayra Melanie Guevara de Beltrán.
Present, teacher.
Nelson Edgardo Sánchez Ramírez.
Present.
Ofelia Orellana Arce.
Good, teacher.
Osmin Baires Olórzano.
Present, teacher.
Rafael Ernesto González Ventura.
Here.
Roselena Salgado de Serrano.
Present.
Sandra Gladys Méndez de Barahona.
Present, teacher.
And Jancy Lisbeth Hernández Mejía.
Present.
Thank you. Edwin Rolando Méndez Chicas.
Present, teacher.
Giovanni Alexander Mengíbar Rivera.
Here, teacher.
And Zulma Rosaura López García.
Present.
Thank you. We're 21. Okay. Let's continue. So let me just check something really quick here. Today is Monday, May 3rd. Today, Ofelia Orellana Arce, you have 10 minutes tonight. You stay tonight, okay?
Yes.
From 10 to 10:10 a.m. Good. Okay, yes. And let me check really quick here. 9 o'clock. It's 9 o'clock on a Saturday. It's just things about formal and informal phrases. Best response to the statements. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Hmm. Okay, yeah. Let's go to page 38 of your manual. Oh, wait. Let's go to page 37 first. So we're going to work together. Look at page 37 on your manual. You have a crossword again. First, let's find these words. Have we done that? We haven't done this, right? Every unit, you have a crossword. Okay, pregunto, no hemos hecho este crossword, le hicimos el de la unidad pasada, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, okay, good. Okay, so let's find these words again. And second point, you have to choose 5 words from the word search and write a sentence per each. How? With models. Okay. Mm-hmm. For example, you should apply etiquette wherever you go. You should apply etiquette wherever you go. Okay. You can not avoid the company's guidelines and etc. Okay, so let's find the words first and then we create 5 sentences. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, good. This is page 37 of your workbook. Got it?
Got it.
Got it.
Yes.
Okay. Let's go, guys.
Good evening. Share pantalla, qué sé yo.
Print.
The screen.
Mm-hmm. Share the screen.
Could you share the screen?
Please? Excellent. Could you share the screen? It's the most appropriate okay. way.
Okay.
I can.
Voy a ver no, qué tengo but... que aprender a hacer eso.
What can share screen? Who?
Okay, if no one can share the screen, use the chat. Use the chat, the Zoom chat.
Okay.
You can use the Zoom chat if nobody can share the screen. It's okay.
All right.
Manners, uh-huh.
Oh, yeah.
Polite.
Wait.
regards. Etiquette, good etiquette.
Latecomer.
Latecomer. Oh, come on. I just found latecomer.
Oh, okay.
Ella is a teacher.
Hey, good. You did it? Good. Four.
4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Behavior.
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 Ah, oh, just found it. Salutation. Help him, floor. You're just missing behavior and salutation.
Okay, salutation.
Too easy.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh, you got it. Okay. Yeah, I didn't see that. Okay, remember, now you have to create five sentences, okay? With five of these words, okay?
Okay.
Behavior está en la séptima sí. línea, de arriba para abajo.
Sí, de arriba para abajo, sí. Great color está en la 1, 2, 3, en la cuarta columna, en la cuarta columna de derecha, de derecha a izquierda, pero hacia arriba. Late comer. Late comer.
Late comer.
Ya.
Yeah.
Riggers. Ya lo encontraron.
Esta está.
Está en la tercera línea.
Riggers. Ok. Es la última.
Hasta la S, ¿verdad?
Sí. Ahí termina.
Hasta la S. Riggers.
Sí.
Okay. En la tercera fila. La tercera columna.
Yes.
Okay.
Hay un espía.
Okay, remember you have
ahora
to
las
build
oraciones.
Five sentences. Good. Okay.
Five sentences. Yes.
Good, Melanie. Go.
Okay.
Regards. Punctual.
I found it. Regards. About the B of subject.
Subject.
So did the fear
first.
Yes, the first. About the B. Is MMXX. Then became regards.
What is the word?
Yeah, regards.
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 Regards, yeah.
Punctual, regards.
How do you say best regards or best regards?
Best regards. Okay. Regards.
Okay. Regards. All the time I say best regards. Regards. Okay.
Donde inicia la palabra polite, donde está la P hacia arriba.
Salutation.
Polite, okay. Salutation.
Salutation, yes.
Good.
Bye. Podríamos poner yo yo use etiquette always.
les suena, sí.
You should, ¿qué?
You should use etiquette always.
You should always use etiquette.
Ah, gracias.
El always Dios. Siempre, el verbo, la primera frecuencia siempre va antes del verbo o después del sujeto. Ah.
Uh-huh. Ok, sería you should always use etiquette. Okay. Siguiente palabra. Podemos usar puntual si quieren.
Yes. You should be punctual.
You should be punctual.
Punctual. Hmm? Wherever you go. What about wherever you go? Wherever you go. Be with you. Whenever you need someone.
How do you say latecomer?
Latecomer.
Latecomer.
Latecomer. Latecomer. You pronounce latecomer. And it means? What's the meaning of latecomer, Darwin?
How do you say latecomer?
Nunca lo hago, por eso no sé cómo se dice. Tardista. Tardista. Latecomer. Yeah. A latecomer, tardista.
For example,
Mm-hmm. A suggestion, you shouldn't be. Mm-hmm.
Tardista es como llegar tarde. Ah.
That's right. You shouldn't be a latecomer. You shouldn't be a latecomer.
Rafael had latecomer at the work.
At work. Rafael is a latecomer at work.
At the work.
At work.
At work.
Mm-hmm. At work. Yeah. Rafael is a latecomer at work. That sounds good. Good, good, good. Okay, how many do you have? How many sentences?
Three.
Okay.
Podría ser, you should change your behavior.
Perfect. You should change. You should change your behavior. You should change your behavior.
One more.
Una nos falta. Mm.
You have 1 minute. Okay, so everybody shoot me your examples in the chat, please. Shoot me your examples in the Zoom chat. Go to the Zoom chat. Baby, don't understand. We can take the moment, make it last. Could you be punctual at the meeting? Could you have good manners in the dinner? Be careful, in the dinner, en la cena, es porque es una cena muy especial. Acuérdense el uso de la THE, chicos. The dinner, in dinner. You should be more polite. Could you regards your mom? What's the meaning of regard? Regard. What is the meaning of regard?
Saludos.
Saludos.
Oh. Saludos, but when good. when you find someone at the street, you can say regards. Regards.
No way.
For me, it's only for a letter and a mail.
Good. Dejemos claro esto. Regards solo es para una carta. Si lo voy a ocupar en esa manera, could you give my best regards to your mom?
Mm-hmm.
Y eso lo usan mucho los británicos. Could you give my best regards to your mother? To your mother. Okay.
Could you write your mom in your letter?
Yes, something like that. Pero en buen americano, decís, could you say hi to your mom? O simplemente dicen, hey, say hi to your mom. Así, hey, say hi to your mom. Le decís hola a tu mamá. Of course, from my end, de mi parte. Okay, say hi to your mom. Y de hecho es una manera de despedirse. ¿Eh? Say hi to your mom. Where were we? Good. Could you best your behavior? Oh, could you better your behavior? Could you better your behavior? Could you better your behavior? Uh-huh. You could arrive late. Please. You could arrive later. Comer, please. What is latecomer? Latecomer is not a verb, it's not an adjective. Bueno, sí, es un adjective.
Those are persons that come late.
So it's a noun. It's a noun like driver, jumper.
For example, I put my sentence. Later comer person are disgusting.
No. Latecomers are disgusting. If you want to generalize, latecomers are disgusting. That's rude. That sounds rude. Latecomers are disgusting.
Yeah, but when you say somebody, I need you here at 2 and arrive at 3. Tell me.
Oh, yeah. In that context, definitely. Especially if your boyfriend and girlfriend, right? Oh my God. Yeah. She should be more polite in the office. She should be more polite in the office, Sandra. She should be more polite in the office. You should be polite with your boss. Good. And I'm checking. Oh, okay. Darwin Edgardo. Rafael is a late comer at work. Rafael is a late comer at work. Could my employees have a good behavior? Sure. You should change your behavior, Fidel. You should change your behavior, Faltolere, your behavior. You could have a good behavior in the office, in the office. In the office. Okay. Hoy should, I'm going to use etiquette. You should use etiquette. Okay. Would you like to take the class of etiquette? Carla Vázquez, would you like to take, tengo que separar los verbos, the class of etiquette. THS se agrega para objetos comunes. The class, the dentist, the teacher, the classmate, the street, the beach.
Okay.
Would you like to take the class of etiquette? Can you be punctual, please? Can you be punctual, please, Sandra? Latecomer person are disgusting. Latecomer people are disgusting. Person singular. Okay. Could you be my guide? Good. Would you solve this problem? Angela de Jesus, would you solve salutation? What is salutation? The singular of greetings, right? Is a greet. Salutation. Saludo. Always give a salutation in the morning. Okay. Being punctual is important. Osmin, bien. Okay, be careful with that. Being punctual is important. Could you help me with my late come? Could you help me with my late arrivals? ¿Podrías ayudarme con mi llegadas tardes? Melanie? No. With my late.
Con mi trabajo.
Con mi trabajo atrasado?
Tardado.
Tardado, sí. Atrasado.
Sí, my pending.
Atrasado, ajá, o sea, my pending atrasado. Job. Okay, porque latecomer es tardista. Okay, entonces para decir, could you help me with my pending job? My delayed. Podría decir pending or delayed. Delayed job. Pending or delayed job. Okay. Good job, guys. Let's continue. We're almost done. Now, let's move to page 38, where you have to identify. Okay. If you need to use would you mind or could you for the following sentences. So you need to identify three mistakes in the requests below. This is very easy. Come on. Remember the structure of would you mind. You need to use ing after would you mind, remember? Yes, teacher. Okay, good. So you need to use
yes, teacher.
ING after would you mind, okay?
Mi micrófono se traba, teacher, y no puedo correr.
It's okay, don't worry. Okay, select.
Sorry, teacher.
Hey, number four, select the most appropriate answer for the request below. Would you mind turning the lights on? No problem. Yes, I would. Think. Acabamos de ver estos temas. It's very easy. And last, write a suggestion about the following behaviors. A suggestion here, right next to this, or right down below. Okay, you have to write a suggestion right here. Okay, my Sara never stops chatting on the phone when we have lunch. Oh my God. Okay, a suggestion. What should Sara do? What should Sara do?
Puede caer WhatsApp. Se puede caer Instagram. Se puede caer.
Okay, yeah, se puede caer las redes sociales y sigue. Yeah, that's not okay. Okay. Now, let's classify. Look at this. Classify these salutations and closings into formal or informal. See you. Hey, what's up? XOXO, oh my God, on an email, XOXO. What is XOXO, Melanie?
Abrazos.
And? Sí,
besos.
Besos y abrazos. Yeah, XR, kisses.
Soxo.
Uh-huh, soxo, that's right, soxo. So-so. ¿Ven por qué no me gusta que digan soxo?
No diré más seguido.
No. When I ask you, how are you? So, so.
Class, no.
Okay, you don't do it. Okay, good guys. So in groups, we have three, four activities that we have to complete. Just move this to this spot, okay? To this part. If you see it is formal or informal, okay, write a suggestion for each sentence. Select the most appropriate answer out of the two options you have and identify three mistakes out of these five sentences, okay? Simple. I'll be there with you. Voy a estar ahí con ustedes, okay? Group by group. Let me recreate the rooms again. Please work, let's do it. You can do it. We're almost done. Let's go, guys.
Hello.
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 Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello, hello. ¿Me escuchan? Hola.
Of course.
Yes, okay. Es que como me salí, estoy viendo las capturas de pantalla.
Gracias.
How do you mean mistake?
What?
How do you mean mistakes?
Mistakes, errores. Identify and correct.
Y corregir tres errores. En los recuerdos abajo.
Yes. For example, and the number one, would you mind moving your car? It's blocking mine. There's a mistake. There's a big mistake. Because the correct, I think, is could you mind moving? No. No, would you mind moving my car? It's broken mine. Would you mind?
Would you mind?
¿Te importaría?
Puede, te podría mover tu móvil.
Yeah.
Tu car,
would you mind moving your car? It's blocking mine. I think it's correct.
It's correct.
For me, correct.
Sentence
correct. Yeah, yeah, I understand that. You could fill this purchase order. You could.
Podría usted.
I think that is.
Marcar la orden.
Mm-hmm.
Pero fill this.
I think that is you can fill.
Because first is called and second you.
It's a question. Could you fill?
Ahí hay un error entonces, porque full
ya. Entonces, disculpen porque a veces se escucha que estaba hablando.
No se preocupe. Sí.
No me recuerdo si siempre después de que va would you mind, si va el verbo con ing, pero cuando solo va would you, también. Por ejemplo, en la 3, que solo dice,
ajá,
would you sending.
Sending.
No. No, porque porque no hay otro verbo.
Ese
digamos.
Es
ajá. Entonces sí.
Es mi hermana la que dijo incorrecta, disculpen. Está complicado. Voy a quitar el micrófono.
Vaya. Entonces sería would you send. Nada más, ¿verdad?
Sí. Sí, porque no va el mind.
Uh-huh. Ajá, por eso es que poníamos ahí en fin el otro.
Ay.
Ay, maybe.
Ay, yo, sí, está bien.
Yo,
assistant.
Terminamos, solo eran tres errores.
Sí.
Uy, sí, solo tres.
You have to continue with the other two exercises or three? Three.
Yes. Me avisan cuando lo hayan copiado.
Ya está listo.
Ya.
¿Ah?
Ya, le tomé screen.
Vaya.
Vaya.
Será más fácil.
Ahora hay que seleccionar la respuesta más apropiada. Sería, yo pienso que es la A.
Es que dice, ¿podría ordenar algo de comer?
¿Podrías ordenar algo de comer?
Ajá.
No está preguntando qué pido.
Is a yes or no question.
Pensemos, ¿podrías ordenar algo de comer, por favor?
Yes, I could.
Sí, sí puedo, sí podría. Sí podría.
Ok.
Ajá. Ey, está bien pizza.
Yes. Está bien pizza. Las dos deberían ser correctas.
Mm-mm. No podría contestar solo. Sí, sí podría.
Está bien pizza, Eva.
Sí.
Está bien pizza. ¿Es pizza okay?
Sí, es como que.
Pizza okay.
Imagínate que, bueno, no sé. Estás sentado con alguien, con tu compañero, y te agarra el pelo con su silla. ¿Podrías mover tu silla? Sí, sí podría. Okay. Ya sí, ¿verdad?
Ya entendí, teacher.
No se me ocurre otro ejemplo, perdón.
Okay. Okay. Bien, claro.
Thank you. Yes, please. Right away, I could do it. Sí, sí, esa, la mayoría de preguntas son así. Would you mind getting 10 copies of this report?
No, I...
Ahora, quiero que les quede claro eso a todos. Cuando me preguntan, ¿te importaría? No puedo decir, sí, sí me importaría.
No.
No, no me importaría tampoco, o sea, sino que es una afirmación, tenés que contestar una afirmación. ¿Ya?
In 1 minute. In a minute.
In a minute.
Sure, no problem.
Sure, no problem. It's okay, right now.
Okay. Okay.
Good, good.
Excuse me, could you turn down the burning pit? Ah.
Okay. Podría
bajarle el volumen.
Sí, es que ambas respuestas están buenas. Sí, podría, pero dice, no, no hay problema.
Vaya, ¿cómo sería en la primera?
Y la dos dice...
Tanner started chatting on the phone when we have a lunch.
Sara nunca deja de hablar por teléfono cuando almorzamos. No. Y aquí dice que se escribe una sugerencia. Sería de ver Sara, no sé, deja de hablar.
No, deja de chatear, dice ahí, como de escribirse, chateando. ¿Cómo escribir? Ajá.
Así es cierto.
Entonces ajá, la sugerencia.
Sara. Sara. ¿Podrías dejar el teléfono mientras almorzamos?
O guardar, ve.
Guardar, very good.
Keep your phone.
Ahorita.
Could you put off the phone until we finish?
Yes. Sarah, could you put the phone away for lunch? Is possible, teacher?
But wait.
Wait for lunch.
Could you wait for lunch?
Uh-huh.
So it never stops chatting on the phone when we have lunch.
For lunch.
La siguiente. Next.
Next, my boss does not like to
walk.
That's when he walks. When he meets.
He shouts at me from his desk. Okay, so he should.
He should.
Should walk to my desk.
He should walk to my desk. Instead of screaming, right? Alwin! Oh my God.
Oh, you should send me a message better.
He should send me a message instead. Instead, very good.
Para mí, pero...
Yes, it depends the person.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, the number two is the mistake is in the structure. Yes? Could you fill this purchase order? And the third second, would you send this invitation to your assistant?
Could you mind?
Okay, would you mind or could you send? Would you mind? Okay, would you mind sending this invitation to your assistant? ¿Te importaría enviar? Okay, but it depends on the context. I think this case is in my work. I request.
So sin ING.
For me, it's could you send? Because mm-hmm. I think I say with send my workers.
So yes, number three is incorrect, but you can say, would you mind sending this invitation to your assistant? Okay.
Thanks.
Or would you send this invitation to your assistant? It's okay. Would you send? Would you mind sending? One or the other, okay?
So far is correct.
Both, yeah. Two ways is correct. I've been searching for a girl who loves me, but I love you. Let me tell you now, every girl I ever met took my heart, leave me sad. What am I, what am I, what am I supposed to do? Oh, 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 ah, hello.
Con t-shirt se me reinició el celular. Es mala hora. No sé ni qué pasó, sinceramente.
Okay, boys and girls, we're done. I'll see you tomorrow at the same time. Ada Patricia Linares Galdames.
Present.
Ana Michelle Guevara Sánchez.
Present.
Ángela de Jesús Santa María.
Present, teacher.
Azalea Melanie Guardado por ti y yo.
Present, teacher. Good night.
Good night. Darwin Edgardo Ayala Leiva.
Present, teacher.
Okay. Good night. Fidel Coreas Pascual.
Present, teacher.
Flor de María Carballo Ugarte.
Present, good night.
Good night. Gloria Elizabeth Linares Galdames.
Here, good night.
Good night. José Ángel Pereira Romero.
Night.
Good night. Carla Vanessa García de Pérez.
Present.
Thank good you. Night. Good night. Carla Verónica Vázquez de Rivas.
Present.
María Estela Varela Velázquez.
Present.
Mayra Melanie Guevara de Beltrán. Okay, Nelson Edgardo Sánchez Ramírez.
Present teacher.
Ofelio Oriana Arce. Good night. Osmin Baire Solórzano. Okay, Rafael Ernesto González Ventura.
Yes, tonight.
See you tomorrow, Osmin. Bye, Rafa. Roselena Salgado de Serrano.
Present. Good night.
Here, good night. Yancy Lisbeth Hernández Mejía.
Present.
Thank you. Good night. Good night. Elvin Rolando Méndez Chicas.
Present teacher. Good night.
Good night. Giovanni Alexander Mengiva Rivera.
Present teacher. Good night.
Good night. And Zulma Rosaura López García.
Present.
Good night.
Good night.
Okay, guys. Hoy le toca a Ofelia quedarse conmigo.
Yes, teacher.
Good night. Okay, Ofelia. How are you? ¿Cómo estamos?
Bien, teacher. Lo tengo
a mí no me mencionó, teacher. Bye.
¿Sí? Okay, sí le tomo en cuenta, Sandra. Good night.
Okay, bye. Good night.
Good night. ¿Cómo estamos, Ofelia?
Vi que me cuesta un poquito, pero ya más o menos entiendo unas cosas más. Uh-huh. Ajá, que en veces cuando hablan se me viene a la mente cómo se pronuncia, pero como practicamos con el grupo.
Sí.
Ayuda para poder pronunciar bien. Ya un poquito, siempre me cuesta, pero ya no es tanto.
Pues, nada me cuesta. No se diga que le cuesta algo. A ver, ¿qué está haciendo fuera de la clase como para ir mejorando o ir adquiriendo, no sé, como más conocimiento?
Los sábados me pongo a oír videos de inglés, a escuchar música, porque en vez hay un video que sale que uno repite las palabras que cuando va cantando. Uh-huh. Y voy repitiendo para que no quede.
Y entre la semana, Ophelia, ¿no le queda como un espacio, no sé, una hora que se pueda sentar a escribir?
A veces no, pero a veces sí.
Ok, pero que usted pueda hacer el tiempo una vez al día, unos 30 minutos al día, yo sé que es bien complicado, pero eso le recomendaría yo. Con todo lo que ya vimos hasta este punto, podría agarrar un cuaderno en blanco y empezar a hacer la tarea, nada más. Solo la tarea. Sí. Yo sé que la pronunciación del inglés es lo difícil. Sí. Pero la estructura es lo más fácil de agarrar. Entonces, uh-huh, si usted ha visto en cada módulo, yo siempre hago esto, mire. Uh-huh. Les pongo el sujeto, ¿verdad? El verbo, uh-huh, les digo el complemento. Vaya, uh-huh, este es el presente simple, ¿verdad? Uh-huh. Y lo ocupo para decir yo, cómo. Yo almuerzo a las 12, vaya. Ay, para decir que yo almuerzo, digo have lunch.
Have lunch.
Ajá, y luego digo la hora, ¿cómo es la hora? At 12. Tan fácil como eso. I have lunch at 12. Y ahí voy. Luego agrego, luego la hago negativa y digo I don't
lunch.
Esto siempre va a ser lo mismo. El complemento. Vea, el presente simple. Presente simple. Uh-huh. I don't have lunch at 12.
Uh-huh.
Ok. Y la pregunta. Empiezo con el auxiliar. Do I have lunch? Y sigo el complemento siempre lo mismo. At 12. Vaya. Entonces, ¿qué estoy haciendo? Estoy siguiendo las fórmulas que hemos visto. Aquí tengo un sujeto, el auxiliar con el negativo, ¿verdad? Ok. El verbo otra vez en su forma base. Y el complemento. Y en la pregunta, lo mismo, ¿no? El auxiliar nada más, ahora en positivo. El sujeto, el verbo. Ok. Y luego el complemento. Ahí está. Va. Entonces, no se me olvide el question mark, signo de interrogación. Ahora, puede ser que yo estoy en la clase y estoy poniendo atención, voy agarrando algo, entendiendo un poco, más ahora, este día todo fue en inglés. Ok, entendí algunas palabras y las fui atando y las anoté. Pero, si de verdad quiero aprender esto y empezar a ganar $700, $1,000 al mes, que no es broma, si se puede, ok, voy a hacer un máximo esfuerzo y todos los días, media hora, ok, un día sí, un día no, una hora, ok, en un cuaderno me pongo a hacer positivo, negativo, pregunta, positivo, negativo, pregunta, ok, eso me va a ayudar mucho. ¿Sí? No me puedo quedar solamente con lo que voy viendo en la clase, porque entonces no es lo mismo. Mi recomendación es esa, que procure hacer esto, ¿no? Y no sé si, eso sí creo que lo ha tomado nota, ¿no? Que cada tiempo gramatical sí, que hemos ido viendo, en especial cuando vemos eso de la estructura, del sujeto y todo, de eso tome nota, y lo único que tiene que hacer usted es ir reemplazando. Si dice sujeto, ¿cuáles son los sujetos?
El verbo.
Ah, los sujetos, acuérdense. Yo, tú, él, ajá. Ahora en inglés.
Es I, you, she, a.
She.
She.
She, ok. Un objeto, digo. It.
It.
Ok, ajá.
They.
We.
We.
Ajá, ahora sí.
Ajá.
They. Ellos. They. Ajá. Desde ahí puedo empezar a recordar todos los días. No me he aprendido de todos los sujetos. Vaya, voy a cerrarlos y los voy a poner por escrito con su significado. Ok, ahora los verbos. Ahí mandó el listado de verbos el teacher. Ok, voy a buscar. ¿Qué podría decir? Y ahí empiezo a cuestionarme. ¿Qué sujeto podría aplicar? Ok. Voy viendo la fórmula. Sujeto. Dijo que después llevo un verbo. Ok. ¿Pero qué podría decir después del verbo? Si digo I eat. Yo como. ¿Cómo sigo entonces? Me voy al traductor y le pongo lo que ya sé. I eat. ¿Qué podría poner? ¿Cada cuánto? Every day. Podría decir que como. I eat bread, I eat meat, ¿ya? Eso necesito que usted agarre. Yo conocí a alguien cuando estaba cuando empecé de profesor en otra academia, les contaba en cierta ocasión, una persona muy, pero muy humilde que trabajaba vendiendo pastelitos, mamá soltera, tenía como 34 años. Y mire, no es mentira, Ofelia. Ahí fue donde surgió esta idea de la tarea, de estar repitiendo todos los días. Se apegó tanto, esa mujer necesitaba tanto incrementar sus ingresos por su hija, porque era madre soltera, que todos los días hacía la tarea. Todos los días, y siempre me andaba buscando. Y a veces me daba cosas porque me decía, teacher, disculpe, yo sé que aburro. Al principio, ¿verdad? Después ya se nos hizo costumbre estar platicando y, ajá, no, hombre, esto es así, dale, que no sé qué. Hasta me programaba yo y le decía, ay, ¿qué onda? ¿Vamos a hablar ahora? Sí, me decía, ¿qué quiere usted esperando? Ya me decía. Y me esperaba a mi hora de almuerzo porque yo tenía media hora para comer y ahí a la ligera, ajá, vaya, esto, chivo. ¿Alguna otra pregunta? No, teacher, eso. Y no es mentira, Ofelia. Yo me fui de ahí, después me la encontré 2 años después, trabajando en un call center. 750 al mes, y me contó que, claro, me abrazó, se puso a chillar cuando me vio de la emoción, y me contó que todavía estaba vendiendo pastelitos la mamá. Ahora la mamá vende los pastelitos, ella solo llega, va, vieja, aquí está el dinero, mira, para más materia prima, híjole, el negocio creció y no le falta nada, gracias a Dios. Entonces se puede, pero hay que hacer ese pequeño sacrificio. Estoy a la orden si usted me quiere escribir, ¿ok?
Gracias, teacher.
Buenas noches.
Buenas noches. Night.